New day, new you. Today, we are talking Alzheimer's in honor of Alzheimer's Awareness Month. And we are joined this morning by Betty Kemper. She is the founder of Kemper House and Cognitive Wellness, and Dr. Nate Bergman as well, who's joining us from Kemper Cognitive Wellness. I thank you both for coming in this morning. It is an important month, that is for sure, to shine some light on this. And I know with Alzheimer's and dementia, more than 50 million people are touched by this. And a lot of people feel like there's nothing I can do, and they ignore maybe early signs. But you don't subscribe to that.
Yeah, and it's really not us. Recent FDA approvals for medications like Aduhelm and Leqembi are transforming the landscape in Alzheimer's and changing people's idea of what's possible. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, as of fall 2023, the potential negative effects of these medications, both costs and side effects, have left people or given them some pause. The good news is that people have much more control than they thought they did just by basic lifestyle and daily habits. There's so much you can do to prevent and intervene at an early stage in Alzheimer's. So it's a great time of hope.
It is a great time of hope, and I think that's what's so promising about this. And I know personally, you, your family have been touched by Alzheimer's, and for generations too. And your husband, so near and dear to your heart, is someone who was affected by this. So what do you have to say to those who either might be afraid of experiencing it themselves or for someone that they love?
The first thing that I really urge people to do is to get tested. This is very personal for me, mainly because these therapies were not available for John when he was diagnosed. The tests are fairly simple, and they're non-invasive. They are very personalized because every body is personal and different. I cannot urge anyone, there is no downside to getting tested, and that way you would know and have the knowledge of whether you have a chance of having Alzheimer's or other dementias.
And when you say to just urging everyone to get tested, you mean anyone, right? Whether they have a family history or not.
Yes, absolutely. Just because you test and may have a percentage of having Alzheimer's does not necessarily mean you will get it, but it will give you insight into what you can do about it.
I know, Dr. Bergman, there is a very exciting and hopeful study that's taking place there at Kemper.
Yeah, we're honored to be one of six sites in the country that are trying to reproduce the results of a pilot study that showed 84% of people that had cognitive loss showed signs of improvement. So if you're between the ages of 45 and 76 years old, you have measurable cognitive impairment as outlined by the study, you can go to dementiareversaltrial.com. It's dementiareversaltrial.com and get the details of the study. If you are included in that study, of course, it's free. It's all covered. So again, great hope, really kind of an exciting time in the world of Alzheimer's and Alzheimer's prevention.
I mean, when you just see that clip that we have up right now, that image, for the first time in history, Alzheimer's is a choice. I mean, that's something I'm not sure even 5 years ago, a decade ago, that we would have thought that for that to be an option.
It was not an option when my husband was diagnosed at all. At that time, he literally was told to call back in a year, and they would see how far he had progressed. And
it's
basically
terrifying.
There's nothing to do about it. But that is not true today. Today, you can do something about it. And I urge everyone to at least get tested and know what your chances are.
I know, Dr. Bergman, there's a fear that comes with this diagnosis. And that sometimes fear is what stops us from taking action. And I'm guessing you would encourage everyone to put those fears aside and take the action.
Yeah, I think at this point I would say if someone's willing to make a change, they should definitely look and get tested, because there is an enormous amount that you can do if you're just willing to get tested and then take action.
Dr. Bergman, Betty, thank you both so much again for coming in today and shedding light on this very important topic. Thank you.
Thank you.
New day, new you is brought to you by Kemper Cognitive Wellness, one of the nation's leading brain health centers.